Hello friends, in this video I will discuss about this speed and then I will give you few questions to solve. So let's start with the speed. Speed. You have studied that a body is said to be at rest when it does not change its position with respect to its surroundings. While a body is said to be in motion when it changes its position with respect to its surroundings. Clear? So your position is not going to change now. Clear? You are not changing your position. Means what? You are at rest. And after seeing the video, when you will go to another place, go to another room, then that is called as a motion. Clear? When a body is in motion, the length of path traveled by it in a certain time is called the distance moved by it in that direction. Duration. This is expressed in the unit meter and the symbol is m, small m. We see many moving objects around us. To find which one is moving fast or slow, we measure the distance traveled by different objects in the same time interval. For example, if we compare the motion of a car and a bullock cart on the road, we find that a car travels more distance than the bullock cart in the same time interval. So what we can say? Yes, we can say that the car moves faster than the bullock cart. So, the idea about the motion of a body, that is how fast or slow it is moving, is obtained by a quantity known as speed. So, we can define speed as, okay, this you can write as a definition of a speed. Clear? Now, the distance covered by a body in unit time is called the speed of the body. I repeat, the distance covered by a body in unit time is called the speed of the body. So we can frame the formula of the speed, and the formula of the speed is equal to distance traveled divided by time taken. Okay? Yes, speed is equal to distance traveled by the body divided by time taken. Speed is usually denoted by the symbol v, small v. If a body travels a distance d, small d, in time small t, then its speed is given as v is equal to d by t. The SI unit of speed is meter per second, and the CGS unit of speed is centimeter per second. Sometimes we measure distance in kilometer and time in hour. Then the unit of speed is kilometer per hour. Now we will study about the relationship between kilometer per hour and meter per second. So 1 meter per second is equal to 3.6 kilometer per hour, or 18/5 kilometer per hour. When you will solve 3.6, you will get what? 18/5. Clear? From this also we can say, what we can say from this? Yes, 18 kilometer per hour is equal to 5 meter per second. Clear? What? 18 kilometer per hour is equal to 5 meter per second. Now I am giving you the relationship between centimeter per second and meter per second. So 1 meter per second is equal to 100 centimeter per second. Clear? 1 meter per second is equal to 100 centimeter per second. Now, one question for you. Do anyone know about the speedometer? Have you seen the speedometer? Okay, I'll tell you. Clear? I'm going to tell you about it. Speedometer is used to measure the speed of vehicle. Vehicle like car, scooter, etc. at that instant. So you must have seen speedometer where? Yes, in car, in scooter. Clear? That is called a speedometer, and that is used to measure the speed of a vehicle. Now, note down few questions from the screen, solve it, and in case you get any problem, please ask without any hesitation. Okay? Thank you.